standing in a little patch of shade right now. I look like a weirdo, but I've always said that, oh my god, I'm gonna get a babysitter and I'm gonna do this and this and this and this, and now today I actually have a babysitter for the day and I don't know what to do with myself. It's crazy. So I'm just walking up the street. I need to get some lunch. I don't know where to get lunch because I'm on my own now. It's weird. I don't have Remy, but I walked by this place. It's called Sakti Healing, and I thought, you know what, I don't have Remy with me, I'm going to get my tarot card read. So I'm pretty excited. I wasn't able to do this with her before because she's just too squiggly and it needs to be quiet and concentrated to get your reading done. So today I'm going to do that. Unfortunately, they were all booked up, but I got a business card so I can make an appointment for next time I get a babysitter. I don't know what to do with myself. I just went to a cafe, had a coffee, was able to drink my coffee. So that was pretty nice. And now I actually have a scooter lesson. I've driven scooters and dirt bikes before, but the traffic here makes me really nervous. So I'm just taking a lesson from a local and he is gonna teach me the ins and outs of Bali traffic. Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. You dropped the sookie right out of your mouth. I love you. I love you. Today, we're getting up, getting ready, and we're going to go to Denpasar. My driver is actually here now, so I'm trying to hustle and get everything ready. We're going into Denpasar because I need to extend my visa for Bali. With a V. Your mom's crazy. Bali with a B. I need to extend my visa for Bali with a B. And I don't know why I said Bali. That was really weird. So anyway, my mind is like all over the place right now. I'm trying to hurry. Okay, let's get you in your car seat first off. Let's get you in your car seat first off, bud. Okay. All right, we got the darling in. Okay. Wow. I am super like crazy right now. I didn't have coffee yet, so we're going to stop for coffee. And yeah, we're going to go extend our visa because whenever you arrive, you have two options when you arrive in Bali. The first option is arrive for free, right? And you can stay 30 days. And then you have to leave. You cannot extend your visa. The second option, my key is stuck in the door. The second option is paying $50 when you enter. So it was 50 for me, 50 for Remy, $100 total when you enter. And then you can extend your visa for another month whenever you get here. So we paid the money when we first got here. Here, baby, do you want to hang on to the key? Don't drop it, it's very important. Okay, let's not drop it though. Okay, let's not do that. Alright, so Remy and I paid the $100 whenever we first got here. And then I went to a visa extension company, which does all the work for you. But now we have to go get fingerprints and photographs taken in Denpasar for the visa extension. So we're gonna go do that this morning. And we need to get coffee as well. Yeah, tap on these stairs again. Whew. Can we stop for a coffee, please? Thank you. flat white with almond milk, please.
Take away?
Yeah, take away. Oh, I might have to get another 5. Just a sec. Thank you. Sorry for all the little cash. Good boy. Good boy. So cute. So the GoPro is doing this thing where it doesn't want to turn on and off again. I took the battery out. I'm just going to let it cool down because it feels quite warm. So hopefully that's that. We got our coffee. Give me a really weird cover. Yeah. And we're on our way. Just leaving the immigration office now. They have a problem with the server. It's pretty common, I guess, and it can't be fixed today, so we have to come back tomorrow pretty early. Hopefully we can get our visa extended then. We got Remy all ready. I'm wearing my flashy kikas. I just wanted to change it up a bit. I'm gonna put a bunch of rings on too because I feel like a bling bling goddess kind of day, you know. Even Remy agrees. Did you hear that? All right, so I need a coffee and then we're on our way. You too. The cafe that I usually go to didn't have any electricity, so I went to this place called Mustache. I must hash a coffee. I must hash a coffee. Mustache. I must hash a coffee. I must hash a coffee. Do you must hash a coffee? Mom is silly, huh? Yeah. Okay, day 2. We're going to Denpasar again. We're going to the immigration office again. The first time I was there, there's a system error, which I guess is pretty common. I was talking to my visa agent and he said it happens quite often and that you can either wait, but sometimes it doesn't get fixed in the same day. So I'm coming back again today and hopefully there's no error so we can get our visas extended. Right? You wanna get it? Remy has banana bread all over her, if you're wondering what that was. It's just banana bread. We decided to leave a little bit early, so we're there at the office at 8 instead of 9. But yesterday we got there at 9, and it was just pretty full when we got there at 9. So we're going to try an hour earlier and go from there. So hopefully it's all good. I look really tired because I didn't have my coffee yet. Okay, that was very quick and painless. Just took some fingerprints, a photograph, and it was done. I was expecting to do an interview, but they didn't really ask me anything. And then the hardest part was getting a picture of Remy, as you could imagine. Basically like a passport style photo, no smiling, no glasses, and yeah, she just didn't want to pay attention, so that's what took the longest, but still, I got there at 7:40, and I'm out at 8:04. Remy and I are both on different passports. Remy has an Australian passport, I have a Canadian passport. So when we first arrive at the airport, we're both eligible for visa-free entry. And you just pretty much walk into the country for free, and that allows you to stay up to 30 days. I'm going like 30. That's not 30 bucks. But you can't extend it. It's another option if you want to stay longer, or, you know, if you just plan on touring around a lot. Pay at the airport an extra $50 per person. They will give you a little letter in your passport. They actually stamp it right in there so you won't lose it. And it's basically the okay to go get your visa extended. You had to go to a visa agency. We had to go get an agent. You can do this on your own, but it's a little bit more tedious, and I just suggest paying that little bit of extra money and getting someone else to do it, you know? That's what they're for. They're there to help you. So anyways, we went to a place called, where did we go, Remy? We went to Bali Visa Extension Agent. Pretty straightforward. I went to this one. It's located on Raya Samet, and I went here. I chose this place because it's relatively close to where I live, but also it had 4.7 stars. So I went through, I read the reviews, because you do have to give out your personal information, so it's very, very, very important you do your research and make sure you're going to somewhere reputable. While I was there at the visa extension agency, they ask you for your information, they ask you for your passport, and then you have to pay the fee. I forget what the fee is, but I know it was over $200 for both Remy and I. I think it came to like $220. You can also choose different timelines. So I chose the cheapest option, which takes about 15 days, but you can also get an express option, which takes about 3 to 5 days, I think. And then there's an option that's in between 2 weeks and 5 days. So it depends on how long you plan on staying in Indonesia. If you plan on traveling, obviously the express package might be better for you. Remy and I planned on staying in the same spot, so it didn't really matter because we weren't traveling. We weren't planning on leaving the country, so we did have the time. So what happens after that is you have to leave your passports at that company. This is why I said make sure it's reputable. I know it seems sketchy, but that's just how they do things here. So I actually left my passport and my daughter's passport in the hands of a stranger for 2 weeks. Yeah, pretty sketchy, but you know, it turned out good. Again, you make sure they're reputable. Reputable. Next thing after that, I got a text from the woman that I left my passports with, and she told me, okay, you need to be at the immigration office in the city of Denpasar at this specific time and date. So the next step, obviously, to show up on the time and date. It took us about an hour to get to Denpasar from Canggu. We went there the first day, and obviously, as you've seen in the video by now, the systems were down, which I didn't know this at the time, but apparently that's a very common thing to happen. So we booted her back home, and then the very next morning we got up. We actually left a little bit earlier this time. I guess if you go earlier in the day, you have a better chance of getting in, because once you are there, the lineup starts getting longer and longer and longer and longer. But again, I got there early, and I was the second person in line today, so we just pretty much went up to the counter, they gave me a ticket, and once your ticket number is called, you go up. What happens is they take a picture of me, they take a picture of Remy, they take my fingerprints, and usually they would take Remy's fingerprints too, but since she's so young, I just had to sign off for her. Very, very, very quick process. It was a little bit more time consuming with Remy because you need to get a straight on photo of a wiggly baby. Yeah, that was that was a challenge for sure. But we did it. It was very quick. And now I'm waiting for another text from my agent. They're going to tell me when to go pick up my passport. I actually saw my passport and I saw Remy's passport when I was in Denpasar today. The guy who took our photos and fingerprints had them with him, so I do know that they are in safe hands. And you just gotta trust the process, you know? It's just how it's done on the side of the world. So it was a little bit nerve-wracking to not have your passport. Like, that is the most vital piece of information you need to have on you when you're traveling. So to give that to somebody and just have full trust in them. Yeah. But we did it. We did it. That's the process. And now we can stay in Bali for another 30 days. So we're pretty excited about that. Okay, and now for the rest of the day, I just literally need to go take this to the laundromat. I need to go to the Circle K, which is just across the road. I need to get a bottle of water. I buy them by like the jug. You can't drink out of the taps here. So I feel like I'm constantly, every day I go and I buy like a 4-liter jug of water. And I'm like, oh, this will last a long time. And then it just never seems to last a long time. Constantly buying water every day. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna drop my laundry off, and I'm feeling kind of tired, but I'm just debating, like, should I buy a coffee, or is that gonna keep me up all night because it's now the afternoon? I don't really know what to do. I'm just gonna go get our things done, and I will see you in the next vlog, y'all.